morning. Today is Tuesday, May the 25th. It's good to be with you today. Hope you had a good night's rest. I certainly did. And just thankful for another day. I want to encourage you to share this video right now. If you've got the share button there, if you can just hit that so others might be able to join in with us. A couple of things I want to make you aware of. One, actually, yesterday Leah had to take Constantine to the hospital because he was running a fever, and appears that he's just gotten some kind of infection. Praise is that it's not COVID, so under the treatment with chemo, he's very susceptible. And so just praying for Constantine today that he would have complete healing from this infection. And we're just believing that God's turned around his cancer situation and that God's going to heal him is what our prayer is. And so just continue to pray for the Petresca family. They're still going through it. And pray for Matt and Terry Meyer. They've been having a lot of challenges as of late. Matt's mother has been diagnosed with cancer. Terry's dad's heart condition. And then this last week, a drunk driver on Sunday morning had run into both of their vehicles and a lot of damage to their vehicles. Praise the Lord. The cars were there and didn't come into the house. So just a lot of needs in the body. Just remember to pray for each other. And again, now that several have joined us, hit that share button on your Facebook Live feed just so others can share along with this. This morning I was reading in Ephesians, where we're going to be looking at today, beginning in verse 14, I think it is. Verse 14 of chapter 2. And it talks about Jesus being our peace. And an old song came to my mind that came out in the early 90s, I think, that you might be familiar with. There's a ladies' echo part to this. So where you are, if you want to sing along with me in this, it's called You Are Holy. You are holy. You are mine.
I will live.
I will listen, and I will love you all of my days, and I will love you all of my days. I just love that song. I love that declaration in the verse that we declare that He is holy, He's mighty, He's worthy, and I will follow Him all the days of my life. Why do we follow Him? Because He is holy, He's mighty, and He's worthy of our praise. This morning, as we pick up in Ephesians chapter 2, if we remember, yesterday was Paul was reminding these Ephesians that though they were Gentiles, they were a part of what would be called the uncircumcised by those who were a part of the circumcised, speaking of the Gentiles and Jews, that they were once far off from God, but now they've been brought near to God. Once they were separated from Him, but now they have been brought in Him by Christ Jesus. Once they were far off, but now they're brought near. And then he picks up in verse 14. And 14 is going to answer the question, how is that made possible? How is it made possible that you and I, who were once far off from God, were brought near to Him? And Paul answers this question in verse 14 when he says, "For He Himself is our peace." Jesus is our peace, who has made us both one and has broken down in the flesh the dividing wall of hostility. The particular dividing wall of hostility that Paul is talking here about here is not necessarily the wall of hostility between Jews and Gentiles, although we can make that application. What he's speaking of particularly here is there was a wall of hostility between you and me and God, that we were enemies of God, Paul says in Romans, that we were once at enmity with God. We were enemies with God. And it's not that God made us His enemy. We made God our enemy by rebelling against Him. And so this wall of division, this wall of separation between us and God was brought down. There was reconciliation. Peace was made with God through Jesus Christ. Now, we can certainly make that application in our lives. The correct interpretation is that wall of hostility between us and God, but we can make this application in the one another's, that a dividing wall of hostility, whether between, in this particular case, the Jews and the Gentiles, it can be made between any segment of our culture or society. It can be that dividing wall between race or ethnicity, and we know that that is a huge deal right now in our country. And can I say this? It's always been there. From the dawn of sin entering in the human race, there is a wall of hostility because of sin, the result of sin. There are walls of hostility in families because of sin. There are walls of hostility between different cultures and ethnicities, pockets of that in our country and around the world. And it will be that way until Jesus comes back. And that's not a reason to say, well, it's just that way, we'll just live with it. No, we as followers of Christ, because we've had that wall of hostility removed, that barrier between us and God removed by Jesus Christ, we are called to be peacemakers. We have the Spirit of God living in us, and we should not be a party to division because of any race or ethnicity. We are ambassadors of Christ, where He has called us to be peacemakers. Jesus said in the Sermon on the Mount in Matthew chapter 5, "Blessed are the peacemakers, for they shall know God." So God has given us that ministry of reconciliation Paul talks about in Corinthians, that we have a ministry that God has called us to be agents of reconciliation. How is all of that possible? It's not possible through legislation. It's not possible through edicts. It's not possible through the flesh. It is only possible through the shed blood of Jesus Christ. And so we, as Christ's followers, need to be agents and instruments of that peace. The Bible speaks of God's peace really in three different ways. Probably a couple of other ways, but primarily these three ways we'll find the Bible speaking of God's peace. That there's peace from God. That really the only person, and he is a person, but the only one who can give peace is God himself. There's peace from God. Why do I say the only one that can give peace is God himself? It's because we are all racked with a sin nature. We're incapable of bringing that. It's only peace from God. Then the second way the Bible talks about peace related to God is that there is a peace of God. It emanates from God. And so we have peace from God and we have the peace of God that he gives. Subtle difference, but there's a difference. And then lastly, and this is most importantly, the Bible speaks of having peace with God, that we have peace with God now. How and why? Because of Jesus, who has been the instrument of the peace of God. So we have peace from God, peace of God, and peace with God. But know this, that we will never know, a person will never know fully the peace of God until first they have peace with God. So if one is not experiencing the peace of God, it's because they don't have peace with God. And so there's that initial peace that we have with God when we trust Christ, and now we've been reconciled to God through Christ. But there's that daily having peace with God. I can once again make myself hostile to God by being in rebellion and sin against him. And so if a person is not experiencing peace of God, it's either, number one, they've never been reconciled to him through Christ, or they're in sin and they fail to recognize that sin and they have failed to make peace with God. So daily confession is what's necessary there. And so he says he himself is our peace. How? By abolishing, verse 15, the law of commandments expressed in ordinances, that he might create in himself one new man in peace in place of the two, so making peace. You see, there was that written law that we've all violated. And here it says that Jesus abolished that. Now, it doesn't mean that he did away with the law. He fulfilled the law in keeping every one of the commandments of the law. And so he has gained that for us, so that by placing our trust in him, we now have peace with God. Verse 16, and he might reconcile us both to God in one body through the cross, thereby killing hostility. One body in Christ. One body in Christ. And if we think of it in a world scale, that wherever we go in the world, whatever culture, whatever ethnicity, whatever tribe there might be, we all are one body in Christ Jesus. And one day, when we're there with him in heaven, as recorded in Revelation, every tongue, tribe, and nation will be glorifying him. Why? Because what we have wanted to accomplish in the flesh, what we've wanted to accomplish on this side, cannot be done because of the sin-racked world that we live in. But one glorious day, my goodness, we will be of every tongue, tribe, and nation praising him around the throne. I look forward to that day. Verse 17, and he came and preached peace to you who were far off and peace to those who were near. Christ preached peace, not the kind of peace we think about, of let there be peace on earth. Listen, he preached peace that begins with having a relationship to God through Jesus Christ. That is our message of peace. That is the message that we are ambassadors of to carry to a lost and fallen world. Pray today that God would give you an opportunity to plant a seed of the gospel in somebody's heart so that they might know that peace with God that only comes through Christ. Pray that God would give you wisdom to see where someone has already had a seed planted in their heart and you're able to cultivate that seed of the gospel. And man, I'm asking God, let me witness you save somebody today, that I can see somebody come to know Christ today and then have peace with God. And through that peace that we have with God, we are now able to be ambassadors of that peace by the Holy Spirit of God. It can only come one way. Folks, the answer is Jesus. The answer to the world's ailments, the answers to the world's problems, the answers to the world's strife is Jesus Christ and Jesus Christ alone. But remember, we are agents. We are ambassadors of that peace. We're to carry out his message. I love you. I pray the Lord's blessings on you today, that he would keep you. And just a heads up, this is Memorial Day weekend coming up. And Monday, Memorial Day, there will be no daily devotion. So we have tomorrow, Wednesday, and Thursday, and then we'll have a break until next Tuesday. So I pray the Lord blesses you, keeps you. Share this, if you will. Hit that share button. I love you. Look forward to seeing you tomorrow morning. God bless.